Thank you very much. Welcome to the Jazz Ensemble, as you can say, spring concert. That first tune was a very old tune, written in 1920, credited to Al Jolson. Shows you how old it is. A tune called Avalon that was arranged for the great singer Anita O'Day by Bill Holman. That featured Miss Rachel Tregoose on vocals. I also got a little snippet of Jorian Dawson on alto sax there. As well as a much bigger snippet of Adam Garcia on tenor. This next song is actually going to feature our entire trombone section, which isn't a phrase you hear every day. In fact, we have in three different jazz solos as well. So this is a tune that was written by a great trombone player named Frank Rosolino. It's called Blue Daniel. This was arranged by another great bell trombone player, arranger named Rob McConnell, who's a Canadian big band leader and great arranger that was done for his band. And this is going to feature, like I said, all of our trombones. We'll do some the name calling on them later, but this will be Frank Rosolino's Blue Daniel.
Come on.
Man, that was terrible. I didn't have anything to talk into for a second there. All right, so first of all, trombone section. Give it up for them. See, soloists in order. And Daniel Brooklinger, trombone. I guess I don't need to say on trombone. You get the idea. Kyle Chappell on trombone. I can't not say it, apparently. Patrick Harwell. And the rest of our trombone section also had, standing now, Ramiro Cortez. And on bass trombone, Michael Johnson. All right, this next tune was written by the great saxophonist Don Menza for the Buddy Rich Band in, I think, 1976. This is a rock tune that's going to feature some saxophone battling between Jorian and Anthony Soriano on the Barry Sax, as well as little Peyton Burns on drums doing his Buddy Rich playing rock impression. But this is a tune called Beulah Witch.
Thank you.
saxophone, Dorian Dawson. From Little Horn to Big Horn, there, Anthony Soriano on the band. And tearing it up back here on guitar, and the whole reason we brought the whole pedal board today and everything, Gary Burkhardt on guitar. All right, this next tune is going to go back about 30 years from where we just were. It was originally written for Duke Ellington's performance at Carnegie Hall in 1946. This next tune was part of what he called the Deep South Suite. It was a four-movement suite that he wrote specifically for that Carnegie Hall performance. Though he never recorded the full suite, and pretty much within a year of playing it, had dropped all of the movements except the fourth movement, which is called Happy-Go-Lucky Local, which was another one of Duke Ellington's kind of train songs. There's a few songs that are kind of about and centered around trains, Happy-Go-Lucky Local being one of them. So this tune remained in his book for the remainder of his career. Pretty much the band played it until he died in 1974. That will become significant in a second. I won't say anything about it until afterwards, but as you hear this tune, aside from all the great individual solo work of the line, which Duke Ellington was known for writing, you'll also probably hear a very familiar tune about the midway point of the tune, a very familiar melody, and we'll talk about that afterwards. Let's see if you can identify that melody. But this will be Duke Ellington's Happy-Go-Lucky Local. Thank you. Okay, so first question, what tune was in there? Or what tune that we now know is from a different name is in there?
Night Train.
Yeah, Night Train. Popular blues, kind of blues standard Night Train. Well, as I said, this piece is written in 1946, recorded originally in 1946. In 1949, one of the tenor sax players at Dumont with band was a guy named Jimmy Forrest, who then in 1951 ended up publishing under his own name, under his own authorship, a tune called Night Train, which ended up being the number one R&B hit in 1951. It's kind of become a ubiquitous blues tune that most everybody's heard in one form or another. Duke Ellington, probably because he didn't want anybody coming back on him, didn't ever pursue any kind of legal action or anything, but quite obvious where the inspiration for Night Train came from, for Mr. Forrest there. That kind of interesting about, and again, you can see why Duke Ellington's band was so popular for his, why he inspired such loyalty, that he would, in every piece, write so many features for every, like almost, you know, probably half the band, half the horn players had at least little solos in here. We had Ruben Sepulveda played the opening kind of alto wail there. Also had a couple statements from Jamal Edwards on tenor. First trumpet solo, I think we had Scott Crumb play the trumpet solo. As well as some nice plunger work from Aaron Rahi on the trumpet. Now you'd think because Duke Ellington is a piano player that it would always feature piano, but really a lot of his tunes don't feature piano, and even a lot of tunes don't even have piano parts, and he was content to direct the band order. But this one had a little more involved piano, and that was Donald Collins on piano. And you really gotta love a composer who writes a lot of room for a bass solo in a big band piece, because that rarely happens. As Abel Allady is on bass. About a month ago, we had the privilege of having a wonderful trombone player named Conrad Herwood come and play with the band as part of our Hill Country Jazz Festival. And one of the tunes we did with him was his own arrangement of an old, very old standard called Body and Soul, which is usually done as a ballad. In this instance, he arranged it kind of as an up-tempo Latin piece. Instead of Conrad Herwood this time, we got Patrick Harwell playing the trombone solo as well as Adam and Donald on this. This is Body and Soul, arranged by Conrad Herwood. Thank you. and tenor sax. Donald Collins on piano. With a nice little nod to Kenneth Herbert there at the end. Patrick Carwell on trombone. And also a lot of good drumming back there for Mr. Israel Yanez. All right, this was actually the last tune that George Gershwin completed before he died in 1937. And usually everybody puts an hour at the beginning, knows that it's Our Love Is Here to Stay. It was actually published as just Love Is Here to Stay, which makes it really hard when you're looking it up in books and things like that, because you never know. All right, this next one's in the future. This is Rachel Tregoose on vocals again. This is George and Ira Gershwin's Love Is Here to Stay. Scott Crumb there on trumpet. And hello to everybody watching the Facebook Live stream. Hopefully there's more than like two watching right now. So this next tune, it seems like this has been a very trombone-centric concert, which there's nothing wrong with that at all. So this next tune was written by a guest that was here a couple weeks ago for the Texas State Trombone Symposium. It was a very well-known trombone player and composer that works out of Las Vegas. His name is Nate Kimball. He's a fantastic player, but also a very prolific writer of songs. And one of the tunes that we did with him, this tune we're going to do next, is called Gaia. It's a very kind of modern 3-4 tune that's got a lot of very interesting harmonic things going for it, as well as some very cool melodies. This will feature Adam again on saxophone, as well as Nathaniel McKay on trumpet. This is Nate Kimball's Gaia. Thank you. Thank you so much. Yeah, Adam Garcia, tenor sax. And Nathaniel McKay on trumpet. See, we're just about ready for our last tune of the night, which I'm sure is a big bummer for you, but it is for us too. Who hasn't been introduced yet? We should mention one more time, I'm playing all the lead trumpet for us tonight, Mr. Aaron Rahi. And also rounding out our fine trumpet section up there, Mr. Josh Torres. One of us that didn't get me together, but it's going to solo on this next tune. It's perfect timing here. On drums, Mr. Peyton Burns. This has been an excellent time for us. This last one is going to be a test our limits of speed to some degree. This will feature Nathaniel again on trumpet, as well as Jamal Edwards on tenor sax, Donald again on piano, and Peyton. This is a tune written by the great, usually very sax player, Dennis de Blasio, who played with Maynard Ferguson's band for quite a few years. And this was written for Maynard's band, recorded back in 93. This is a tune called Hit and Run. Again, thank you everyone for coming, everyone for watching on Facebook Live. I'll forget about that. Again, thanks for coming. This is our last tune, Hit and Run.
Thank you.